Welcome to PCTV. My name is Ryan Eisenhower. This is Hunter Hummel. And this is our brand new talk-style TV show. We hope you'll like it more than the old format, because it's not the old format. On tonight's show, we have several special guests, including indoor 200-meter national champion Corey Carter, as well as a musical act, the Arctic Monkeys. I've just been informed that our musical act tonight is not the Arctic Monkeys. Thank you. Thank you, New York. But first, several segments.
Currently, the Principia College administration is doing a study on the student experience. If we know anything about our current administration, then we know it's not going to get done. So, PCTV has decided to do their own study. Let's take a look.
Beginning of the semester, not too much to do yet. I got this. Homework is starting to pick up a little bit. Have a few more hours of work to do. I have a chapter test tomorrow, which is fine. I have too much to do. What week is it? Oh, it's only week three. Apparently, week three is when it's all right for teachers to start assigning 10-page paper. Last week was rough. Doing better now. Just had to get through a bit of a rough patch, but now things are all... I want to go outside, but my homework, and then all this, and my to-do list is... Why isn't Canvas loaded? Midterms, you've got nothing on me. Spring break is right around the corner, and I am so ready for a break. Okay, I had a great spring break. Caught up on some sleep, did some homework. Well, a lot, actually. Didn't realize how behind I was. How did I get a 64 on that test? I studied for like 8 hours. This is absolute What the heck? Where is my study guide? I'd be fine with C's at this point. I just want to go home.
Thank you. I think the studio audience would be surprised to know that Molly Lovelace is just a theater major.
Yeah. And being a theater major that she is, she did a great job acting like she actually does anything. Oh! Next up, have you ever rolled over for your 8 a.m. class and then laid in bed for a few minutes thinking, is my education really worth it? Well, some teachers force you to get out of bed and make your education worth it with a strict attendance policy. Here, we take a look at one such class.
Why is it so dark in here? Are we watching a movie?
Yes, but we have to deal with something first.
Okay.
You've missed this class 6 times.
I was on the endless 3 of those times.
Lies!
Melody showed me your Snapchat stories.
Melody, what the f***?
You know the attendance policy. You read the syllabus.
The syllabus what now? I'm 70% sure this class isn't a Spanish class.
The syllabus. We go through it at the beginning of every semester.
I have no idea what you're talking about, boss.
Times are changing. Attendance policies are getting stricter. The days for skipping class and going to Mavis are over.
I'd kill for a coffee right now.
Silence!
I'm sorry, but you've been kicked out of the class. The tribe has spoken.
So you're telling me I never have to come to this 8 a.m. ever again for the rest of the semester?
Yes, but there are far graver repercussions. You must go to the registrar's office. A failed grade will forever be on your record. You've made a mockery of this class, of this institution. I won't stand for it any longer. From day one, you've never taken Maple Syrup 101 seriously. Have you got anything to say for yourself?
Woo! Woo! Yeah. Maple Syrup 101 may not seem like a real class, but just consider that every soccer player is required to enroll in it as soon as they get on campus.
With that being said, I think it's time we introduce the band, not the Arctic Monkeys. And before they go on and do their whatever they do, I just have a quick question. Yeah. Besides all owning leather jackets, when did you know you wanted to form a band?
Well, I mean, it was too soon for the memoirs, Hunter, but, you know, we don't have the intellectual capacity to write a novel together, so we thought we'd do a band. Well, I guess that sound means it's the end of the interview. Now for the bonus question.
I'm a puppet on a string, Tracy Allen, Chan Traveling Diamond, could have shaved hard eggs, come to find you, pouring some velvet morning, years too late, she's a silver lining, lone ranger riding through an open space, in my mind when she's not right there beside me, I go crazy, cause here isn't where I wanna be, and satisfaction feels like a distant memory. What I'm trying to say is I need the deep end. Keep imagining meeting, wished away. Entire lifetime's unfair, we're not somewhere misbehaving for Jay's great escape. Lost track of time and space. She's a silver lining, climbing on my desire. And I go crazy, cause here isn't where I wanna be. And satisfaction feels like a distant memory. She's a silver lining, lone ranger riding through an open space. In my mind, when she's not right there beside me, I go crazy, cause here is where I wanna be. And satisfaction feels like a distant memory. And I can't help myself, all right. Wanna hear her say, is I
We've got another song for you coming up, but first I just got to tell you a quick story. So I was paying for my lunch the other week. It was actually quite a few weeks ago, seeing as it was in October. So I was at the till of the cash register, and you know, behind the lady manning the till was a selection of Halloween cookies. And one of them was a ghost cookie that looked particularly tasty. And so, You know, I said, can I have one of those ghost cookies as well? And she said, yeah. But right across the way at the other till, the other cash register, a lady said, could I just have one of those ghost cookies? So I turned back to the lady and I said, you could say they're selling like ghost cookies. And she said, what? And I said, you could say they're selling like ghost cookies. That's a true story. You and your shoulders are frozen. Oh, but shout an explosion. Your name isn't real, but I don't care for sounding lights. And I fuse my resorts in a bang, 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 oh. I bet that you look good on the dance floor. I don't know if you're looking for romance. I don't know what you're looking for. Say, I bet that you look good on the dance floor. That's a two electro form like a rover from 1984. From 1984. Because it's sending me to despair. Without a sound, yeah, you're calling me. And I don't think it's very fair that your shoulders are frozen. Oh, but you're an explosion. Your name isn't real, but I don't care for sounding lights. And I fuse my resorts and I bang, 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 oh. I bet that you look good on the dance floor. I don't know if you're looking for romance. I don't know what you're looking for. Say, I bet that you look good on the dance floor. Electro walk like a robot from 1984. From 1984. I know there ain't no love, no. Won't you use our Capulet? Just banging tunes and DJ centers. Dirty dance balls and dreams of naughtiness. You look good on the dance floor. I don't know what you're looking for romance. I don't know what you're looking for. Say, I bet that you look good on the dance floor. Dancing to electro pop like a robot from 1984. Say, from 1984.
An incredible performance. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thanks for having us.
Oh, you're welcome.
I can still hear my brain rattling.
And with that, if you'd like to hear more of Not the Arctic Monkeys, they will be playing this Saturday on the Chapel Green at the Whole World Festival.
That's right, Hunter.
And if you know anything about Principia social events, then you know there's a max capacity of 10 people.
10
so
people.
So get there soon. Great. And I think it's time for the interview with Corey.
Absolutely. Our next guest tonight is the fastest man on campus not named Ryan. I'm just kidding, I'm still faster. So, without further ado, our guest tonight, this past, when was it? November? February? Whenever it was, won the indoor 200 meter national championship.
So. I agree with that statement.
That's enough out of you, Hunter. Please leave.
Okay.
And in Hunter's empty chair, I would like to welcome none other than Mr. Corey Carter. So, Corey, what is life like now that you have won the national championship?
Life is simpler than ever. Still working those late night pub shifts, doing homework that I don't want to do. That's not me.
Those sure look like great pub shifts, Corey. Now, do you think your sense of style has changed at all now that you can afford whatever you want?
Well, Ryan, I'm not really into the material objects.
The facts really back that one up for you there, Corey. We also heard that you just bought a new car. Is this true?
No, I walk everywhere.
Yep. You sure do. Now, tell us a little bit about your private life. Are you hanging out with the same people now that you did then?
The same three people just playing Fortnite in my room?
Again, sure looks like it, I tell you. Now, we know how fast you are in a conventional race, but how about in a non-conventional race? We took a look. Here on the screen, you'll see Corey and the 97th fastest man on campus, Conrad Peterson. They have spoons in their mouths with eggs on them. This is called an egg race. Riveting stuff. Off to a hot start,
look
both
at
our competitors
form.
Are.
That form is great.
Really is tremendous. Just textbook right there, Corey.
Said it before.
Close finish. And of course, our national champion wins.
Cider first, PCTV. My emotions took over.
That's very understandable. It was a tremendous victory.
Thank you, Ryan. I appreciate it.
And now here we see a response very typical of men that Corey beats in a foot race. Just wonderful sportsmanship here from the Conrad Peterson. Well, Corey, it was great having you. Thank you so much for coming.
Thanks for having me, Ryan.
Give a hand for Corey Carter. Hand for Corey Carter. And now, it's time to pay for all the stuff we filmed this with. Our sponsor tonight is Masterclass. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's Masterclass.
The key difference between the amateur artist and the pro artist is how big your canvas is. In drawing, they say it doesn't matter so much what you do draw, but what you don't draw. And there's a lot that I don't draw. It doesn't even matter what emotion it evokes. I don't know. I try not to think about that when I work. It's too hard. Okay, so going slow can give you more accurate results, but the thing is, you're not going to become a great painter the way other people have done it. That's why I like to do something I call speed painting. Let me show you. See? No one can replicate that, and saves time. No good dialogue just writes itself. You have to, and this is drawing, isn't it? I'm sorry, I do a lot of these. All right, guys, gather around. Not again. Which one would you choose?
Blue.
Why?
Because I'm coloring the sky.
Exactly. Good job. There will probably come a time in your artist career when people tell you that your work is bad or terrible. And to those people, I say, you're probably right. The best artists say, if you don't know what you're not drawing, then you can't never not know what you are drawing. And I'd have to say, for me, I personally don't never not know what I am not drawing. If you really want your subject to pop, you're gonna have to do something like this. See? Now your viewers will know what is supposed to stand out. I learned that one while studying at Office Max. I draw a lot on my acting career for my artwork now. In fact, have you heard the term method acting? I do method drawing. The emotion I'm trying to evoke here is freedom. So what I might take this.
Freedom!
They say that fine arts is one of the most difficult arts to become good at. I disagree, actually. I think you can do it very quickly and very speedily if you have had drawing one and two. There are some essential tools that every artist needs, and one of these tools I'll show you right now. It's a stapler. A stapler is there to hold your artwork together in one piece and also hold your life together. That's what I use it for personally. but I don't know. There's this belief in drawing that you want to make your subject feel at ease. And I just, I don't believe that. All right, take off your shirt.
No, what? Why?
Please just take off your shirt. This needs to be shirtless and I'm not gonna ask you again.
That doesn't even make sense.
Okay, well, I'll have to help you then, so. Please, I need this.
I'm Noah Otter, and this is my master.
Wait, you mispronounced your name.
What? I'm the expert here. You don't tell me what to do. What did I say?
That you know an otter?
I do know an otter. Whatever, you're just jealous.
Have you been drinking?
Drinking what?
My name is Noah Oster, and this is my master class.
That's all the time we have for our show today. We'd like to thank our guests on today's episode, Mr. Corey Carter.
Yes. And the band, Not the Arctic Monkeys.
Absolutely. We'd also like to thank Media Services.
And the Mass Communications Department.
Absolutely. And who could forget our terrific student crew?
And to our sponsor, Masterclass, for such a wonderful video.
Thanks for paying for all of our stuff.
If you are interested in being part of PCTV, reach out to the Mass Communication Department and ask how you can be involved.
Absolutely. And if you want to watch more of today's episode, it'll be posted on PCTV's YouTube page. Thanks for tuning in. Play us out.
It's better to the point when they provoke the punchline before you have told the joke. I see a desperation to be seen staring at the television screen. It's better to the point when they provoke you to tell the punchline before you have told the joke. I'm sorry, Scotty doesn't exist. It wasn't in the top 100 list. And it's the last.